higher ed meeting of April the 18th.
First bill on the agenda is Senate 1809 by Senator LaValle, an act to amend the education law in relation to meetings of councils at state-operated institutions. This bill will establish that council members who do not attend and have not been excused from three of the four required meetings shall no longer serve as members of the council. Such members shall notify the governor in writing of the council vacancy caused by lack of attendance. This bill further provides that at least one of the four regular meetings be conducted during the fall semester, at which time the president of the campus shall report on the state of the college to the council, and provides that the council may establish subcommittees to assist the council with their statutory duties. There are no fiscal implications for the state and no memos of support or opposition.
I just move the bill.
Senator Griffo makes a motion and moves the bill. Senator Ritchie seconds it. Are there any negative votes?
No negative votes.
Bill is reported.
Senate 3880A by Senator Griffo.
I'm just curious. Is that a common problem with college councils?
The answer is yes.
Okay.
The answer is yes. We should put in, as we do when we have trustees who come
attendance.
And with attendance, and people know that this committee is interested in the SUNY trustees' attendance. So it's critically important. A lot of members aren't aware, who don't serve on the higher ed committee, that there are college councils of each of the SUNY, at each of the SUNY colleges and universities. Okay, next bill.
3880A by Senator Griffo, an act to amend the education law in relation to the licensing of orientation and mobility specialists and rehabilitation therapists. This bill establishes licensure for licensed orientation and mobility specialists for vision rehabilitation therapists. This bill would define the practice of orientation and mobility training and vision rehabilitation therapy. It sets forth the educational and training requirements of each and provides for continuing education, limited permits, exempt persons, and special provisions. There are no fiscal implications for the state, and there are memos of support, which you all have in front of you. I can read out the list if you'd like.
It's interesting because finance has asked that this bill be referred to finance.
You are? Okay.
So this bill has passed before unanimously our House. It's a bill. Did this ever reach the governor, Senator Griffo?
I don't recall.
Yeah.
Yes.
Huh?
I don't think
no,
because the assembly, we had some issues in the other House.
Not one on this.
Okay.
Fine. Motion to move.
Senator Colucci, motion to move. Do I have any negative votes? Bill is reported.
Senate 3881 by Senator Hannan, an act to amend the education law in relation to authorizing nurse practitioners to perform functions in conjunction with diagnosis and illness. This bill would allow a nurse practitioner to certify diagnosis or issue an order which is within the scope of practice of the nurse practitioner, but under current law requires the signature of a physician. A nurse practitioner would also be permitted to sign death certificates or authenticate a DNR. There are no fiscal implications for the state. We have memos of support from the Nurse Practitioner Association and the New York State Nurses Association. The State Education Department also supports, and we have memos of opposition from the Medical Society of the State of New York and the New York State Trial Lawyers Association.
Do I have a motion?
Does this bill in any way expand their scope of practice?
No. No, it does not.
I knew the answer.
Senator Stavisky, you're always testing me.
No, that's good.
Keeps me sharp.
No, I just wanted the other members to know that there's no
extension. That's another bill. There's another bill.
I know that.
Okay, motion. Senator Ritchie makes a motion to move the bill. Any negative votes? Bill is reported.
Senate 4630 by Senator Flanagan, an act to amend the education law in relation to access to patient or client records in the investigation and prosecution of professional licensing and misconduct proceedings. This bill amends Section 65068 of the Education Law as it relates to supervision by the Board of Regents. Pursuant to this subsection, the Board of Regents is currently authorized to designate a professional conduct officer, who is the chief administrative officer of the Office of Professions, and who is responsible for matters in conjunction with professional licensing and misconduct and criminal matters. This provision would allow the chief administrative officer, in furtherance of his or her responsibilities, to supervise the practice of the profession, to obtain records of patients or clients in any investigation or proceedings by the department. A safeguard exists whereby the information obtained must remain confidential and cannot be further disclosed, except to the extent necessary for the proper function of the department without express consent from the patient or client. The name of the patient or client may not be disclosed by the department at any state of the proceedings unless the patient or client expressly consents. A valid court order is required for any further use or dissemination of the information obtained from such records. It's an SED program bill, and we have no memos of opposition.
Any questions, any comments? Do I have a motion? Senator Stavisky, seconded by Senator Griffo. Any negative votes? Bill is reported.
S-5515 by Senator Grisanti, an act to amend the public health law in relation to the employment of persons to function as central sterile supply personnel in certain healthcare facilities. This bill would require that hospital central service technicians be certified and participate in continuing education. Central service technicians are individuals whose job it is to prepare, distribute, and control the sterile and non-sterile items and equipment used in all clinical areas of a hospital. Currently, hospitals handle this training in-house. There are no fiscal implications for the state, and we have memos of support from the International Association of Healthcare Central Service Material Management, the Association of Perioperative Registered Nurses, and the State Education Department supports. No memos of opposition.
We're hoping this will further reduce infections at hospitals.
Motion to move.
Senator Carlucci, motion to move the bill. Any negative votes? Bill is reported. Thank you.